Hello, you've reached Melody's phone. Don't bother leaving a message, because I probably won't listen to it.
You have 112 new messages.
Melody, it's Tommy. You know, your landlord. I know the times are hard, but you need to pay that rent.
Melody, it's 12:30. I've sent you another message about your expenses.
Hi, Melody. This is Candy. From RVs R Us, if you've got your RV all ready for Burning Man.
Melody, it's Sam. Don't forget dinner tonight. I'm sure you're looking forward to it as much as I am. Can you just tell your teenager not to make things too weird? Ta.
London is going through the greatest property boom in history, and I'm missing it. Because of you.
Tommy is pretty pissed off about the rent, Mel. He said if you don't pay it, he's going to come back to London on air miles and garrote you with the dental floss. I'm not sure that's even possible, but if he's willing to use up his air miles, he must be really fucked off.
Melody, it's David Klein here. I would very much like to meet you for lunch. Shall we say the Patricians Club at 2 o'clock?
You must think I'm such an idiot. I don't understand any of that.
I wouldn't say you're an idiot.
Oh, well, maybe it's just too much champagne.
It's really very simple. Our new product is a medicine based around a chemical compound called vincyclidine. Going to make us pots of money.
Excuse me, Miss Munro.
Yes?
A telephone call for you at the bar.
Oh, how old school. I'm so sorry. Will you excuse me?
I'll be right.
Okay. Don't go anywhere. Melody Munro.
£5,000 on a Winnebago rental.
Perhaps you could tell me how your work demands any need for luxury motorhome.
Excuse me, sorry. What desserts do you recommend?
The souffle is very popular, but personally I recommend pear tart.
I'll have two of those. Oh, and the bill. My guests will be leaving soon. Alan, stop talking. Clients just spilled the beans. I've just sent you the recording of our conversation and my write-up. I'll be back in 3 weeks after my holiday.
No, you will not. You will
be in my office in... How the hell did she...
Fucking badass, eh, la?
Thank you, Barry.
I'm so sorry about that.
So, what do you say we get these to go? I know a very good and very discreet hotel around the corner.
Oh, David, that sounds wonderful. But I've got things to do, sorry.
Well, come on, sack that off. I'm not buying you lunch so you can go back to emails and photocopying.
Yeah, I don't really do photocopying in my work, David.
Of course, I'm sorry. I'm sure your role is very important.
Yeah. I work in competitive intelligence.
You're a corporate spy.
Oh, actually, we're trying to get away from the whole spy thing.
But what I've just told you is it's commercially sensitive. It's completely secret.
Sensitive, yes. Secret, not so much anymore. Oh, wow. This has been an expensive lunch.
You whore.
No, David. That's what you thought I was. I am fucking you. Just not how you imagined.
So there's 100 pills, your 2 ounces of Charlie, 2 bowls of liquid ketamine, and my own special mishmash, 2CI, 2CB, MCAT, and a couple of others that haven't come out yet. Will that do you?
Alan?
I found another one.
£2,347 on flowers in May.
People like flowers, Alan.
Clean out my flat so much. Maybe you could find it in your barren heart to pay me some fucking rent.
Lisa, I've done more for this flat than you've ever done.
It's probably true, but I also own it, so...
Unless we enter a state of pure utopian Marxism in the next 24 hours, you pay me some rent, or you get the fuck out.
Goodbye.
It's amazing.
You got me. We want to put him in a good school, but we've got to do this in order to do that.
So yeah, it's important.
Do. You're basically going to inflict a religion on your child because you want to put them in a particular kind of school.
Yes, you've absolutely hit the nail on the head. That's exactly why we're doing it.
Oh.
Sie können nur essen sehr dried rice.
What did he say?
You can only eat the third one. Third rice, third...
Conceptual.
Mm. Please, try this for us. Oh.
Shit, the bed. Is it meant to taste like that?
Oh, it's political.
Wow. I mean, that's exactly what this christening needs.
No. What this christening needs is mini shepherd's pies from a reputable caterer. That's what this christening
Samuel,
needs.
Samuel.
I'm just saying.
Just remember why we're here.
Yes. Dear sister, we have come to ask you to be Auden's godmother.
Is there a polite way for me to say no?
Nope. And renounce Satan, yes, that is what I will be doing.
Wow. Mum and Dad would be so proud.
Oh, everyone thinks God is bullshit, Melody. You just have to believe in a good education for our child. Sam?
Well, look, I'm going to be on a low serotonin come down from Burning Man, and I really don't need to be having flashbacks in a church.
Who on earth is Bernard Mann?
So you're taking your teenager to the California desert for 2 weeks so he can give away hot dogs to people on drugs?
He's 20, it's 3 weeks, and they're burgers.
And why do they get burgers while I'm meant to serve fascist Uncle Ben's at my firstborn's christening?
They're placenta burgers, cooked by the power of the sun.
Of course they are.
Good an appetite.
It's anti-Semitic pastry.
Yeah, it's a swastika. But it's art, you know, it's conceptual.
It's got sprinkles on it.
Oh, sprinkles? Oh, hundreds and thousands. Representing the hundreds and thousands who died.
Millions of people died, Saskia, in the war.
Millions. Thousands. Tomato. Keep
Babe!
What?
Babe, we're going to Burning Man.
Oh, well, what time is it?
11:30. Look, made breakfast. By the way, I tried to buy an industrial magnifying glass with a card, but it got declined.
What card?
The one you said, with the horse on it.
Fucking Alan Day, such a fucking...
off yet. Get out.
All right. You can't try and sack me.
Try and sack you?
I'll take you to tribunal.
I've been in this game a lot longer than you, Melody. I've seen that cry on demand trick before.
My parents died 3 years ago, the day before Christmas. My boyfriend is a 20-year-old fucking concept chef. If you let me fall, there is no one to catch me.
I want the mobile, the day pass, and the Range Rover keys. Now.
I have been a customer at this bank since I was 7 years old. No, I understand that, but... Can you please, please just extend my overdraft? So I just don't understand how it can take a week to do a background check. No, I'm not going to a fucking payday loans company. Well... So I'll just be 2 minutes and I'll get some cash.
We don't need money, babe. There is no money at Burning Man. Listen, I'm saying we just rock this stage with nothing but each other, a freezer full of placentas and a dream.
Come on, Harmony, we do need money. What about petrol, water in the desert?
Babe, in Cuba, they make the petrol out of sugar cubes or canes. Look, and people gift us water. And you've always wanted to go to Burning Man. You said we paid for it all. We might as
babe,
well go to...
come on.
Oh, babe, I'm sorry. I'm being selfish. We'll go next year. Or never.
Babe, I'm sorry.
No.
We can get money.
How?
Going to Burning Man.
Going to Burning Man?
Going to Burning
Man. Oh, fuck. I love you.
Yeah, sorry about that. Took a bit of time. Honey, we're not flying over the Atlantic in a small plane with propellers.
I don't have not been much since flying over.
Well, hello, if it isn't Lofty the Land Baron.
Yeah, great, whatever. So I'm getting pretty fucking pissed off about this flat, if I'm being honest. So I've spoken to the agent. And I'm putting it up for rent.
What? You're evicting me?
No. Well, yeah, obviously, yes. I am.
Look, I'm sorry, this is a really crap time. Can I just call you back? I'm just going into a meeting.
No, wait, Tommy. I will get you the money. I will pay the rent.
Sure, whatever. Okay, so there's a guy in Charlatans coming this afternoon to take photos of the flat. When it's online, you're free to spend the £5,000 like anybody else and rent it.
I've got £1,010, Tommy.
Well, that's £3,990 to go.
What, is he kicking you out?
He's taking my home.
Mel, we'll be on one of those planes in a second. Oh my God, babe, look at the propeller. Babe, come on.
You can't put it online if they can't get into the flat.
What?
If I can stop them taking the photos and doing the floor plan, then that will buy me the time to get the £4,000 for the deposit, and then I can keep the flat.
But, babe, the trip. Do you know how hard it is to get 300 placentas in California?
This is the last call for passengers.
Look, babe, some of the biggest food blogs in the world going to Burning Man. They're really changing what food is out there.
Food is just food, okay? They are not changing what food is. They're just a bunch of twats pissing around in the desert.
I find it hard to believe that you think food is just food.
This is my home. We have to defend it. Come on.
There's nothing else but placentas on the Post Cuisine circuit right now. It'll be yesterday's news next year.
Showtime.
Is this even legal, Melody?
We're at war here, Harmony. Legality is a luxury that we do not have. Okay, look, babe. I know that you're upset, but this is important. And that's why you can do your food concept thingy here in the flat.
Love plus food? Uh-huh. Here? Uh-huh. But you said you'd rather be gang raped by koala bears.
Yeah, but I basically realised it's a really good idea.
Yeah.
First, we've got to stop this fucker from getting in.
Okay.
Oi! Charlatans, get the fuck out!
Get back off!
Get the fuck out of my house!
What the fuck are you doing? Are you fucking crazy? Bastards!
Rick?
This?
Basically medicinal. I've only been drinking vodka and barocca this morning.
I'll be back, you bastards!
Hey, no, you little shit!
Oh, gosh, this place is worse than fucking Johannesburg on a Friday fucking night.
Melzy, babes, how's it going?
You tell me, Charlie.
I'm fucking mental. You would not believe where I ended up last night. Check it out. I had sex with that guy.
That's a wonderful image, Charlie. So, what have you got for me?
Right, what have I got for you? Okay, here's the thing, Melzy. You are what we like to call in the headhunting industry, a person who I cannot get a job for.
Charlie, you tapped me up 3 weeks ago saying that you could get me a job anywhere.
Yeah, I did, but that was before you went around stealing from your employer and blackmailing him, you know, which all in all makes you look like a bit of a crook.
I'm just being honest, thank you very much.
I won Intelligence Monthly's Industry's Most Promising this year and 2013.
Well, that is awesome.
That is a prize that they give to the most successfully duplicitous person under the age of 30 in an industry that's based on nicking other people's information. They want crooks.
Okay, between me and you, the economy is awful.
Charlie, I'm about to be evicted. I need money.
You've got a lovely figure. Why don't you become an escort?
What? Is that the advice you give to all your clients?
Only my fit ones, who are otherwise completely unemployable. Or you could be a drug dealer, except you trouble the police and it's bad for the environment. Sell a kidney?
Wow. Thank you, Charlie. Your help has been invaluable. I mean, how would your mother feel? So, how much for a kidney? I'm fucking ashamed of you.
According to the blood report, technically you're not even alive.
Yeah. Do you realize that this line's recorded? Yeah? I can categorically state that I do not intend to and have never been involved in any insider trading or libel fixing.
Oh, come on, banker boy. Surely you and your little banker friends must have fiddled the figures at some time.
Why don't you just go to a job centre like a normal person?
Sam, I'm not a normal person. There's no way I'm going to go to a job centre. You know, this whole thing would be so much easier if you just gave me £4,097. Well, not gave.
Lent me £4,097.53.
And I'm done.
Found it.
Excellent.
Ah. What are you going to use it for?
Sorry, it's a bit of a bad line here.
I've just been on the phone to the agent.
And he said somebody pissed on him.
Piss? Or someone pissed on his head? Oh, God, that's awful.
Okay, Melody.
Melody? Melody, do you know what a hostile tenant is? Yeah, it's what they call it. It's what they call it when someone tries to intentionally sabotage the viewings. Do you understand?
Tommy, why would I want to sabotage the viewings?
Dragon activated.
Sê vir pa hy moet die AK-47 in die kombuis sit. OK. Tot ziens. Ek is lief vir jou. Tot ziens.
So, really, I don't need to give you the keys because I'm going to be renting it very soon anyway.
Oh, that's lekker. All I need is a full deposit in cash and clearance of the reference check application, which you will put into this in tray.
Brilliant, yeah, that's great. So in a few days, I'm going to have all of that for you.
No, that's lekker. In the meantime, I'm under instruction that this highly desirable loft space is to remain on the market. So, I need the keys.
Look, I'm sure we can come to some kind of agreement.
Do you know how long I've been at this branch? Months. You can count them. 39 of those have been sales agent number one. You're looking at the best in show.
Wow, do you want a prize?
Every month. Keys. You're playing with fire, little lady.
1 week. 1 week without those photos or the floor plans on the website, and then I will have your money plus a little extra. Just for you.
Are you trying to bribe me?
£100. 300.
I'm an estate agent. We follow a strict moral and ethical code.
£800. £2.45. That is my final offer. Okay, and I'm just going to leave that there in your little special in tray, and I'm going to walk away. Okay?
You want crazy camper? You know that?
How would you rate your Google skills?
Do you mean, can I write?
Would you say you have good interpersonal skills?
Motherfucker! Sorry, Joseph.
Training men. Hallelujah. I'm gonna get out. Gonna get myself wet. Absolutely soaking wet. It's raining men!
Check it out. This company does liquid nitrogen in 19th century milk cans.
Oh, Jesus, Harmony!
Sorry. Lemon, orange, lettuce. Leave that there.
Harmony, there's another one for you. How many did you get? Just put it here. Sit. Oh.
Oh. Sorry, babe. Completely forgot about them. They're probably a bit off by now. Mr. and Mrs. Burton Hall, how are you?
Good.
Mr. Burton Hall, Mrs. Burton Hall, you look absolutely stunning. Now come with me, have a look at this apartment. Beautiful, eh? Watch out for the pigeons, eh? They sometimes drop their business onto the floor, yeah? Now look at this, security is very tight. Even Oscar Pistorius wouldn't be able to shoot through this door, eh? Be prepared to see the apartment of your dreams. Now I'm sure there's a light switch in here somewhere.
Lights!
Jesus Christ.
Lights, what the fuck?
Look, I know we said that we wanted an urban feel, but this is just sick.
Hello, JP. Oh, don't mind us. I was just going to put the kettle on.
Oh, God.
Oh, this is happening again. No, wait. Wait! You have to see past the decor! Oh,
well done, baby.
Still worshipping Satan, then. Yeah.
Said Waitrose.
Tough shit. How can you be this hard up anyway? You must have some of the payout from the restaurant, right? You've spent £230,000 in 3 years.
No, I spent it in two. Well, just under two.
On what? What do you spend it on?
Meals out, mostly. Kitchen stuff.
You're fucking joking me, aren't you? You spent £250,000 on restaurants and kitchen stuff. You're not even paying rent.
Well, obviously, I can't afford to.
Oh, this is mad. This is it. That is... I mean, I don't know what kind of mad that is, but that's fucking mad.
What's mad Auntie Melody going to do, eh?
All right,
Naughty Daddy won't help her.
Okay. I'll speak to Saskia. She was telling me she's got an opening for some vacuous bullshit artist. I think you're wildly overqualified for it, by the way.
Saskia won't give me a job after Godmother Gate.
Yes, she will. But you are just going to have to grovel to her, aren't you? Is Auntie Melody going to have to grovel to Saskia? Yes, she is. Saskia is going to be very angry at Melody, but Melody doesn't care because she needs a job. That's fine, isn't it?
You're a dick.
Yeah, I know. And you're a dick. A massive dick.
Yeah, we've got Cher Lloyd coming in. We're doing this whole Jungle Book Mufasa thing with her. OK. So, Metro bitch. Hit me.
Metro bitch.
Yeah, it's great, isn't it? It's kind of what's trending, but at the same time, a state-of-the-nation analysis. Thackeray meets Wolf, but with Twitter. The red carpet is out. It's opening night. What is the premier Melody Munro Metro Bitch column?
Now.
Just idea shower me.
I was kind of thinking I wouldn't need to interview for this job. You know, Sam said...
21st century journalism is constantly revolutionising. You know, by the time you've written now, it's already last year. Tomorrow's Now has already been snapchatted by a 16-year-old info blogger from Malaysia.
I don't follow.
I've been seeing other applicants for this job, so I guess, Melly, it's just a case of how much you want it.
I'm really sorry about the godmother thing.
Thank you.
So, have the job?
I'm really grateful that you apologised, Melody. And family is so important to me. But, if I'm honest, this other applicant has all the skills to nail this job.
Who is it?
Oh, you know her. Laurie Mills? Yeah, I mean, she really has her finger on the pulse of the Zeitline generation.
She's a massive cunt.
Cunt.
So, yeah, I really think...
Cut.
Just get out.
Cut.
Faster.
Babe, what are you doing? Don't tell me. Listen. Amazing news. You know my Auntie Babs?
Yeah.
The pedo?
Yeah.
She just died.
What? God, I'm so sorry.
No, it's fine. She's now communing with the Lord of Hosts. Imagine that. Anyway, more amazing. I've inherited £4,000.
Harmony, oh, that's amazing.
I know.
It's amazing.
Babe, it means love plus food can now be how I imagined it.
What?
Listen, check it out. Isn't it amazing you always get what you pray for?
Great.
I want you to get down on your knees now and start to praying. Because the Day of Atonement, my friends, is at hand. And he brings not peace. He brings a sword. And behind him is fire. And if you do not adhere to his creed, he will beat you senselessly like someone else's red-headed stepchild. Do not listen to that fat cat in the pointy hat.
Get in! There's one more win, and we're safe. Can't bluff me, as you're from school 17. Harmony, I'm kind of in the middle of something really important.
Mel, babe! Look who's here!
Melody, you're missing the revolution!
Harmony is so totes amazed, BTW. Love and Nong!
What's Nang?
Laurie's gonna come to Love Plus Food and do an article about it for a new Metro Beach column. How Nong is that?
Miss Monroe, I know you're in there.
Fuck.
The hermit crab cannot stay in the shell for too long. It has to come out and breathe. Open! Miss Monroe, you cannot fight with the market. The market is like God. All-seeing, all-knowing, omnipresent. Now open the door. Monroe, please open the door. I don't want to do anything rash.
September, the German ring closed. Armies surrounded the city. Wehrmacht closed in.
Mel, don't leave me standing out here like a twat, please. Got booze.
O'clock. Hey, don't shut the door in my face, because I am about to do something incredibly stupid.
What?
I'm gonna give you the money.
Yes!
Yay, best brother ever.
Now listen, this is a temporary loan from Auden's University Fund. There are rules to this, okay?
Okay, anything.
You need to be a godmother.
Really?
Really? Wow, do you want the money?
Sam, I would love to be Auden's godmother. Oh, I'll be back in a minute.
Where are you going? Yep, that's typical.
Hey! Guys! Hey, guys!
I can take it on!
I can take the flat! I got the money! I can get it to you right now!
It's 8:30, you crazy woman! I'm going home!
Okay. Okay, I'll come see you in the office first thing, yeah?
Get off the vehicle! Get away from the vehicle!
Okay.
Get away from the vehicle!
I'll see you first thing.
Yeah? Whatever!
You in this flat, and I think they should stop you in
bold concepts. Babe, try this. Huh? Try this.
Oh, hey. That's really a lot of salt.
Amazing.
A bit too much?
No, babe, no. Mm. Tell Gandhi there was too much salt. Gandhi couldn't get any salt, so he marched on the sea. Salt caused a revolution. That searing dryness is the taste of a revolution! Suffer.
Visionary. Completely and utterly visionary.
Thanks. It's pretty fucking long, huh?
This is the crest of a new epoch. It's like being in the Cavern Club at 62 or...
Berlin 1933?
Yes, I love Berlin.
Right, I'm really sorry, but we're gonna have to keep the kitchen clear.
Sorry, just trying to say hi to the maestro. Mm-hmm. And also, I did think I'd take a couple of photos while I'm here, just because the agent said he couldn't get into taking.
Oh, well, I'm afraid the flat's not for rent anymore.
Yes, I know. I'm not renting it, so.
And why are you taking photos?
Because I'm buying it. So if you could just move, because you're kind of in my visual space.
My flat is not for fucking sale.
Just take the flat. Take the flat. I accept your offer. Just take
Sir,
the fucking flat.
Sir, put the mask back on.
Why? Why are you doing this?
Just trying to live my life.
No, you're not. You're trying to live my fucking life. Get out.
Mel.
How on earth can I write my piece for Metro Bitch, though, if I haven't tried a
beautiful chef's cuisine? Oh, just fuck off!
No, I really need this
piece. No, don't you dare! Don't you dare take her side!
But what about the food?
Well, you can serve the food to her outside on the street, because that's where she's going to fucking be.
Yeah, well, maybe I will.
Fine. Fine, but you can take all of your twats with you.
Oh, Melody.
Is outside on road. Take your plates. Sitting at tables is so mid-noughties, isn't it?
Harmony? Harmony?
Love the drama. Love the drama. Transformative.
Melody, baby. Great event. Love the drama. Transformative. So I'll be round with my surveyor in the morning. Should have the exchange within the month. Long. Ugh!
I've got it. I've got your dimensions. Nothing can stop the J.P. de Kock 5-day house sale.
No, you can't exchange a property in 5 days.
No, you can't. Not unless your name's J.P. de Kock. I've done the searches. I taught myself conveyance, you lord. I've just done the survey. The market has spoken, and I am its instrument.
But I need a little bit more time.
Another trader jumped off Cockavan's roof the other day.
Oh, well, I would too if I'd eat their food.
Someone's got a feeling I'm on an escalator. Everyone says if you stay on it, you're going somewhere good. Everyone else is on it, so, you know, must be good. It's going up, isn't it? But sometimes you get a feeling that actually it may just end up somewhere completely shit. Or maybe it doesn't end up anywhere at all. Maybe it just keeps going up. Do you ever think that?
What, that my life is a drifting sea of mediocrity and the only certainty is my inevitable death?
Yeah.
No, not really. So what do you think of my plan?
What plan?
Getting Laurie to ditch her article on Harmony and writing an anti-Charlton piece.
I thought that was just a deranged rant.
When did you and Saskia get married?
2011. You were there. You were a bridesmaid, for fuck's sake.
Oh, yeah.
You're being stranger than usual. What are you doing?
Intelligence work,
psychological leverage. You need to find out what motivates people, and then you can use that to manipulate.
She's not going to change her mind about buying the flat because you send her a few emails. People aren't that impressionable.
No, it's not just that. I mean, take Saskia, for example.
What's her core motivation?
I don't know, probably to get other people to give her the perfect life, career and family.
While expending no effort herself.
Yeah, well, I've thought about it, and what drives Laurie is her desire to not miss out, driven no doubt by some deep-seated childhood trauma that her parents didn't take her to Disneyland or whatever.
Still burns.
So all I need to do is convince her that there's more cool in writing this anti-Charlatans campaign than there is in stealing my life.
Fucking hell, Zencora's plummeting.
What? Why are you even calling me? Why do you keep asking about Saskia?
Well, I just want to know about my family.
No. You're doing your spying thing again, aren't you? Yeah, that's what you're doing. You stop that right now.
Thank you, sir.
This talk has helped. Sorry, you were saying?
Oh, yes. Look, this space, it's one idea, I suppose. But look, no one has ever suffered in space. Apart from aliens, and we can't relate to them. We can't. No, for fear to mean anything, it's got to be created in pain, possibly boiled in blood. I've tried it in the past, but I've struggled with coagulation issues. You're getting all of this.
Yeah, this is so great.
Amazing. Amazing. Where was I? Oh, yes. Coagulation. So, what I found, I think, is to offset the... Are you all right?
Yeah, no. What do you think about gentrification?
It's definitely bad. But if you think about it, anything that ends in ation is bad, you know. Industrialization, station, penetration. I know that one's... Well, I suppose it could be bad or good, depending on the situation.
Yeah, definitely. Also, maybe anti-gentrification, it's the new food.
No, I think food is still the new food.
Yeah. But, well, I'm really feeling these anti-gentrification vibes, and I just think that food is so next-gen that it can wait for just...
No, Laurie Mills, food can't wait. My food can't wait. It's too important for that. Look, Nelson Mandela once said, you haven't lived until you found something worth dying for. My food is worth dying for, okay?
God, your hands are so strong.
Frozen and silent, Leningrad refused to die. Bread was now made with sweepings, cattle cake, and sawdust.
Over 2.5 million people are trapped in the city. Over 400,000 of them children.
People ate soap, linseed oil, haze to wall paper.
Saskia Babes totally adored the Charlton thing, but we'll have to run next week. When you gave me the job, you promised me 100% editorial control to guarantee Metro B's authenticity. I truly believe in Harmony Ambrose. Not as vacuous as we thought. Okay. Dongle. Oh, come on, help me.
Shit. Well, at least you remembered it's Auden's birthday. That's something, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, where is the birthday boy?
Saskia's taking him to the floating tot swimming experience.
Oh.
It's my life, by the way.
Sorry, Sam.
What are you sorry about?
Everything.
And I know it's been hard since they died, but you've got to stop doing these mental things, Mel. There are other flats.
Yeah, I know it seems crazy, but if she gets my flat, then she gets my boy and she takes my life, you know? How can't let that happen?
Then come home. Be with people who love you. And forget the flat. And you know, you should forget Harmony as well. Are you doing the crying thing?
Why do I lose everything, Sam?
Oh, fucking hell.
Oh, God, no. Ah, this is silly. I'm just going to clean myself up.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Chicken Park, have you got my dongly thingy? Who gets in now? My office. Oh, Melody, you gave me a fright.
Yeah, I know. I was just looking for the loo.
Oh, really? It's downstairs, same as it was when you grew up here.
Yeah?
Oh, here we go. Toodles.
Toodles. Hello, darling. My name is Saskia Armitage Monroe, don't you know? I work for Zeitline. I work for the Zeitline. I'm the main editor of Zeitline. You know, one of the most important magazines in London. Sammy, remember why we're here.
Sam.
Toodles. Laurie, darling, love the fact you're a metro bitch now.
Zeitmost.
Thing is, Saskia, is it... I'm actually buying Melody's flat through Charlatan, so, I mean, wouldn't that look a bit odd?
That's what makes it so perfect. Its life has lived on the front line of hip London. When you make a stand and don't buy the flat, it'll be a real story. Reportage.
So, you want me to push Harmony's food thing until next week?
Nope. No food thing, just Charlatan's.
I mean, don't you think that's going to hurt Harmony's feelings?
He doesn't matter. Just do it.
Betrayal. Love it. So next gen.
Okay, toodles.
Who's that, darling?
So funny. Great story. Tell you later.
Super.
Our ancestors in caves didn't eat for taste, they ate to survive. And that is the kind of purity of consumption that we need.
My new pop-up will have the need concept. Every meal will be served by a Japanese Shinto priest holding a loaded gun to your head. And that will amplify the experience more than any flavor. It'll be like 1 + 1 = 8. A totally immersive dining experience.
Wow, that sounds great.
Oh, it's better than great. Babe, it's a revolution. That's what me and Laurie have been working on with this article. It's just amazing that this is happening to me, you know? I feel like the luckiest guy in the world.
You're not hungry?
Oh, no, I am. I'm starving. And this is amazing, you know? It's probably the best tasting food I've ever tried. But I shouldn't really be,
What?
Well, look, Laurie says I really need to be 100% brand Harmony right now. And I've already got the advantage of one word equity, you know? Like Boris. Or Shano. Warn. But also live it, you know? Every day is literally a battle against the tyranny of taste. This war of attrition that I've got within myself. Basically, Laurie says I've got to stop eating food that tastes nice. All good, babe?
Do you want to fuck? You do fuck still, don't you?
Oh, yeah. I'm still Australian.
I love you.
Are you talking to the flat?
had nothing to do with it.
Oh, cute. Oh, God. Well, Melzy babes, here you are. Oh, and just look at Harmony. God, if I hadn't been lumbered with Sam, I'd be all over that sexy Aussie bum.
Oh, that's a nice image.
Oh, shut up, darling. You know I heart you.
Hey, God, what has she put you in, eh? Yeah, I know. I feel exactly the same.
So, look, we stop with the tea. Yes, you think so?
Miss out that bit.
Can I just ask a question? Is this coming before?
This bit after. Oh, look. He's worried.
Oh, he's worried.
Come, give me a cuddle. Relax.
Oh. It was a strange phone call, wasn't it, Melody?
What phone call?
Oh, you know the one. One when you rang, pretending to be Saskia.
Dashing.
Hi. Harmony is going to be heartbroken when I tell him after the ceremony that you betrayed him.
Why don't you just stop making things up?
Charlatan's thing was a nice idea, though. Bad luck. Why don't I take him? I'm great with kids.
Look, I'm fine. I can hold a baby.
I think it's probably best, though, if I take him.
Why don't you fuck off and get your own fucking baby?
Why don't we see if you can manage holding this?
Hello. Yes. Is that better?
Yes. Can you get your fucking shit together and stop fucking swearing in the fucking church?
Shall we begin?
Yes.
Our Lord Jesus Christ has told us that to enter the kingdom of heaven, we must repent our sins. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. Hi! Speaking of life, that is why we are here. So, may I ask you to bring the godparents forward?
Yes.
Yes, all right.
Hank!
And just stop right there, yeah.
So just fucking stop. I don't want to hear it.
I took that by mistake.
Mel, just go, okay? I don't want to see you again until you pay me back my child's money. All of it.
Where's Laurie?
Why?
A story she's written is going bonkers on Twitter. Burn charlatans, burn. God, that is so on trend. Oh, Laurie, have you seen this? You're such a clever girl. We've gone viral. Sorry? Burn charlatans, burn. God, it's brilliant.
Well, Laurie, how did you think of that? Oh, I suppose you'll have to publicly refuse to buy the flat now.
Oh, well, we could live stream her telling the agent.
That's brilliant! I don't know about you, Saskia, but I'm really impressed that Laurie would be willing to risk a relationship with Harmony for the sake of the right story.
Yeah.
And I'm not sure I'd be able to forgive someone who did that to me.
Oh, this is perfect. You're such a clever little angel. I'm tweeting Piers Morgan now.
Charlatans is the new form of Chinese cabbage.
I actually like speak up and say, fuck charlatan.
I just know how to tuck a penis up a book.
Hark, Laurie Mills.
Murray Mills is the one. Miss Mills, what's with the video?
I've come to tell you that I think you're a cancer, eating away at society.
Excuse me?
You and your extensive range of high-quality apartments. Apartments is what is ruining the local spirit of my area. You just bring in an influx of wealthy, aspirational, good-looking people, which, quite frankly, I find disgusting.
But it's the market. People want to live in this area. You want to live in this area.
How dare you, JP? I will never, ever buy a property from you.
Oh, my God. That was so inspirational. It's given me an idea for a starter.
Oh, no, wait. Wait, I'm going to cook for you.
Oh. Babe, why are you throwing away a picture of Laurie? Holy shit, it was you.
Just ignore that, babe.
You set this whole thing up? You knew it'd ruin my article.
Did it for us?
No, you didn't. You want this flat so much, you're welcome to it. You don't love me, I'm just another thing to you, like you're... DeLonghi.
Where are you going?
To find Laurie. Someone who wants me to succeed.
Well, Laurie doesn't want you to succeed. She just wants your cock.
Laurie Mills actually cares about my food.
Oh, your food? The food is pretentious bullshit! You still love me, don't you?
Thank you.
Who is it?
Melody Monroe. Bailiffs, collecting on behalf of Show Me the Skrilla. You letting us in? You sure? This hasn't happened before.
Just take it. Take it all.
It wasn't a heart attack. It was an irregular murmur brought on by stress. In fact, saying the words heart attack made me more stressed.
Apparently my blood pressure is the worst seen outside of Japanese mid-level management.
Wow.
Doctor's giving me this heart rate thing.
Okay, listen, I'm going to stop you right there. Look. I want you to sell the flat.
I can't talk about the flat.
Talking about the flat makes me very uncomfortable and nervous. I need to remain calm. I need to remain extremely calm.
Okay, well, I'm going to move back with my brother. And tell me. I'm sorry.
Fuck. Sorry, my heart's beating. Sorry, it's the motion. Fuck. Sunny! Sunny, fucking get in here, Sunny! Fuck, I'll see you later. Ah!
At the moment, but you can still view our extensive range of properties online.
It's Melody.
Step away from this retail property.
I have your keys. You can have them. Wow.
You're joking, huh?
The victor, the spoils. Come on, JP, let's get you a celebratory drink.
Glasses over there.
But, first probably some water, eh?
The Doi Factory.
Oh, Melody. Fancy meeting you here.
What are you doing?
Burn, Charlatan, burn? I wrote it. So now... I'm going to do it. Okay, Glass. Video record. Say my name. I am the Metro Bitch.
Laurie, I wrote it. You know that.
Oh, Melody, you are funny sometimes.
This is really fucking serious.
You're right, Melody, it is really serious. Mel, I found it. I found the revolution. And look, it'll cause a little bit of pain, quite a lot of destruction. But from its ashes, a new world will arise. Better world.
And I'll be the one to capture that. In a kebab.
Okay, right, kids, playtime is over. You can go to jail for this stuff for a very long time.
You can't stop me this time, Melody. Do you know that Bob Marley once said, you haven't lived until you found something worth dying for?
That's Mandela.
Well, I am Bob Marley.
Well, you can be Bob Marley all you want. Harmony and me, we're getting out of here. No. Come on, Harmony. You two. You deserve each other.
She's always been such a dull bitch. Let's burn this fucker.
Hey, Sam, it's me. I want to move back home.
You said this half enough?
Of course. It's blame you just fire. Yeah. Blame the fire. You just did.
No. These guys, they are morons. It was me. I did it. I burnt Charlotte.
Fuck. Fuck
you, Melody.
I'm shut back, I'm warning you.
No, I'm scared.
Where's JP?
He's in the car. Laura's going nuts. We're not violent, officer. Apart from Austin.
Version is yours.
JP, stop moaning. Hey, you've got work to do and I think you've been into it. Come on.
What?
JP, tell him.
The officers, this woman is fucking crazy. I've had enough of this duck. I'm going back to Africa to sell weapons.
JP, you're telling me it was me.
It was her. She's one crazy fucking bitch.
No! Oh, God, I feel good.
Right, lads, it's taser time!
All right, Jones.
Yeah, you know.
How's anger management classes going?
Shit.
It's nice, isn't it?
Stop. How's my nephew?
Good. Pretty good.
Did you get the money that I transferred over for his birthday?
Mm-hmm.
It's only 2 weeks to go.
Fucking hell. 2 weeks. See Laurie's campaign?
What, the Free the Charlatans one?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she's been trying to get in to do an interview. One good thing about prison, you can stop people from visiting you.
Well, she is a massive cunt.
Yeah.
Saskia has said if you want to do a column about being a posh girl in prison, there might be a slot.
Ooh, yeah, yeah. Thanks. I was actually thinking of trying some cooking when I get out. Like, a local restaurant somewhere. Nothing with a theme, not a fucking pop-up.
I was actually quite into the Nazi food. By the way, you know, Tommy's back. I don't know, I thought maybe you guys could
I'd still rather have my old room back with you, if that's all right.
That's fine. Of course.
Good.
Harmony sends his love.
Does he?
No, not really.
Phew.
Gorilla Gourmet, my new cooking show, where we're shooting here in... Where are we? In Ukraine. And I'm cooking a flaming galah. Yes!
How many? I see men in the trees.
Just keep shooting, Anatoly. This is what this is all about. This is a cooking revolution right now. Oh, my leg. Anatoly, mate. I'll get the first aid kit. Anatoly, did we bring the first aid kit?
I have seen the light. Cause the Antichrist is coming too. He gonna be bringing smite and retribution, giant wasps. They be coming too.
How's that? Welcome to JP's AKs. Today we're gonna be selling the best fucking weapon known to mankind. Fucking get some, baby! Yeah! Ladies and gentlemen, we've only got 55 of these AK-47s left. We gotta get rid of them. You know, I don't wanna have to put these in the trunk of my car when I leave here and try and drop them off at a township somewhere. No! These things have to go. There you go, baby. Do you wanna hold that and show them how you shoot? Now look at this. Now you just aim down. There you go, baby. There you go. Get some. Fuck you. When you absolutely, positively must kill every motherfucker in the room, this is the only weapon of choice. Oh, hold on. Yeah, we just sold another 5 of those. You could shoot someone about 1,000 yards with this and still take their fucking arm off. That's just the way it works, eh? Now this is the way I prefer to, give me that there, baby. This is the way I prefer to shoot, yeah? You're gonna take these and you're gonna fucking blow some fucking people's head off, yeah? Like that! Fucking get some! Fucking get some!
I said, you know, Cointreau is for flambéed bananas, but they were drinking it.
Oh, goodness. Horrible.
Well, to bring it back to a conclusion, I think everything has gone most satisfactorily, Mr. and Mrs. Runro, and I really don't have any other questions. It just remains for me to ask Auden if you have anything to add, young man.
Can't.
Are you done digging your grave yet? Put another hole in your paycheck. Are you done?